are cruising Hollywood Boulevard here, but are the LA Matadors cruising to an opening night victory over last year's number two team in the world? Well, it's going to be up to Rau'shee Baby Pitt Warren, the captain of the team, to do what captains have to do to bring the ship home against 19-year-old Khabibulla Akhunov from Kazakhstan, a WSB rookie. I'm telling you, if there's ever a time for the captain to step up, this would be a big night for the Matadors, because this is a really top-notch, world-ranked team. They came just one bout short of winning the world championship last year. Paris beat them. Paris took home $500,000.
Back up.
Kazakhstan lost. So they came out reloaded this year. But
yep,
LA
that's not
also
good.
Is a little better because they have more experience from a year. And Rau'shee is back with them, even though he's already qualified for
ready?
The Olympics.
Ready?
To
back
keep
up.
Himself in good form, he hopes.
Box.
Round one scheduled for five. Your three-time Olympian as of next year, Rau'shee Warren in the black trunks, taking on Khabibulla Akhunov, who steps right on him, he thinks, but there's that quickness and defense of Baby Pitt. He's a southpaw, as you can see. Fighting since he was six. Trivia for you folks have been in boxing a long time. He's from the Westwood community of Cincinnati. He trained at the same Eastside gym where former junior welterweight champion
Much feet
trained. And he's knocking on off balance right now.
Stop, stop, stop.
Hey, stay off the head. Stay off the head.
Box.
Well, a few things have happened. Akhunov has got a great left hook over the low jab of Sweet. But he's got a great left hook. This kid's got potential. He's got a little pop to him, too. He caught Warren once or twice, but then Warren figured out what he was getting hit with, and it hasn't happened again since.
Sup!
I landed a couple of his own, but I gotta tell you, this Akhunov for a 19-year-old kid, he's got some real talent.
That's why he's here on this team.
Watch your feet, gentlemen.
And said this team is the pride of that entire country over there. So you've got to be quality just to make this roster.
Box.
Great counter left hand by Rau'shee.
You see his speed. She's been really busy this summer, coming in bronze at the World Championship.
See, Warren just needed to see those first few punches that he got hit with from Akhunov, and it hasn't happened again since. He's already adjusted, and now he's starting to land telling shots. Case in point, that nice little left uppercut that Akhunov walked into here.
We're in round one, final 30 seconds of our featured bout of the night, featuring two-time Olympian and soon-to-be three-time Olympian Rau'shee Warren, on the right side of your screen, against Khabibulla Ismail-Akhunov. 19-year-old kid's being aggressive as best he can, but he's in against a whole lot of talent.
He just threw some great punches at Warren, who had his hands down at his
waist,
and he didn't touch Warren with one of them. So, see, he's already got his number right now.
Straight.
Not to count this kid out, because you can tell he's ripping hard punches right now.
All right, let's get to know Rau'shee Baby Pitt Warren a little bit more in his own words.
One time left, right. Baby Pitt, three-time Olympian. Remember that. With the right, knock him out, knock him out, knock him out for the night. I've been doing this since I was 6 years old. I'm the only one out of my family that ever got this far, and I'm looking to continue to make history. It look like it's raining outside, because I'm bringing that lightning, baby. I'm bringing that lightning, baby. I'm bringing that lightning, baby. You just got it. Don't leave your seat, because you might miss a knockout.
Well, Joe, you can't hurt what you can't hit.
He's got the qualities of some of the best out there, like a Pernell.
That's what I was thinking. I was going to get your opinion because I know you went against those guys and know what they're all about. I mean,
well, I trained three world champion southpaws, so I know what a good one looks like, and he's a good one, let me tell you.
Nice lead left there from Rau'shee. And he can sting you going backwards, too. Whoa, he whistled a right hand there. He's getting his dander up a little bit.
Well, did you see Warren? He
bounced
off one side
feet.
Of the ropes in the corner to the other side of the ropes, and then under and out. And he's an amazing kick. But Akhunov is still playing heavy, hard leather. And he's not going to give up quite this easy.
My hands are free.
He's going to work as hard as to try to land a good shot. And turn this around. Box.
Shouting USA, USA, they know Rau'shee's pedigree. Just enjoy watching this.
Warren's using incredibly fast twitch muscles here to get out of the way of those counter punches.
No punch, no punch.
He's twitching, feigning, landing, getting out, dipping. All the while coming out of skate. This is a rough customer in front of him.
He's going to come straight forward. These teams from Astana that I've seen the last 2 years, they are all guts and hard-nosed fighters. Training in really rough conditions over here, but the country really has supported them so far.
Stop! Break! Straight back.
When Rau'shee was at the Athens Olympics, teammate, of course, the great Andre Ward, who kind of took him under his wing. 17 years old, he's in the Olympics, Joe. He was the youngest athlete there. Not just the youngest boxer, he was 17 at the Olympics.
Is that his first or second?
First one, yeah. His first one, he tells at Athens, and then he went to Beijing. But, you know, to start that young and realize he's still young.
Right. No
he's 24.
He's only 24. He looks like he's 19, 20. He's got a very young face. He carries himself like a young man. But I got to tell you, he's already an experienced veteran. 330 fights.
Watch your heads. Watch your heads. Watch your heads.
Out of 330
stop.
Fights.
Stop.
It's incredible.
Right.
We couldn't even figure the winning percentage on that.
Box.
Second round, 30 seconds left. Rau'shee Warren in the black trunks. Lead right hand there.
Yeah, he snuck in a kind of a half up, half loop right hand. It landed not with a lot of authority, but it landed. That one did.
That one sure did, that's for sure.
Stop! Stop! Break! Come on, guys, watch the holding. Box!
Nobody read Akhunov Warren's resume.
Listen for the bell.
It's gonna make you engage.
Time.
Yo, I know y'all are gonna have a positive film out of chat, the USA. So let me hear you guys. USA! 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 Yeah. When I say baby, y'all say bit. Baby! Baby! When I say baby, y'all say bit. Baby!
You can talk if you want. Oh, come on. What's at stake for the captain, Rau'shee Baby Pit Warren? Well, his team's all even. They want to start off this season with a home victory before they hit the road. Just take a look at some of the action, Mr. Goosen.
Well, there's a left hand coming back with a right hook off of Akhunov, but Akhunov didn't take advantage of the low left hand like he did right there in that second sequence with the right hand.
Round number three.
Warren cannot get careless with this kid. He's a strong kid. He was the 2010 student world champion finalist. I should say the finalist, but not the champion, but one of the finalists. And you don't get that far unless you're really good.
Actually, what that means, in case people are wondering, the student world champion, that's the college teams that meet over there in that part of the world. They have college boxing teams, so. Not enough room for Rau'shee to get
no knockdown.
Out of the ring.
Watch
what you're pushing, right?
Well, Kumat landed a couple good shots there. After Warren landed a few good shots, they both had a great exchange here. Unfortunately, Warren was against the ropes and got pushed out. So it made it look worse than it really was. But they both got each other pretty good in that exchange.
It was fun to watch.
It was. I don't know if the coaches really had this.
No, not too much of this.
Step! Break! Straight back. No punch. No punch. Box.
Lead left. Rau'shee. No combinations.
Come on, guys. Hands
now.
Are free.
That's how you
Stop.
Get the round back going into your favor.
Stop.
By landing those combinations.
Watch it, sorry.
They weren't answered back
Box.
By
Akhunov.
And Warren's back in the lead.
Isn't it a test of Rashi's nature, too, and this guy just keeps trying to brawl with him that he doesn't lose his cool, Joe?
Stop,
when he's getting
stop.
Pushed around
no punch,
and
no
almost
Straight
there.
Back, guys.
I mean,
Let's go, box.
If you're an experienced fighter, you don't fight his fight, correct?
No, that's true. But, you know, sometimes these guys are on you so hard, you,
right.
you,
end, right.
you either
back,
end up
back.
Running,
go.
Or you've got
hey,
to stand,
head,
make
right?
a stand and fight him a little bit.
Box.
That's what Warren has to do. This kid's putting a lot of hard pressure on him. Oh, it's a nice counter, and then a nice sidestep, and another left-hand counter.
Straight back. Box.
I think he got his attention right there, Akhunov. That was one of those moments where you look in Akhunov's eyes and goes, what am I in against? A ghost? A ghost that can hit you?
Well, he's Warren is very elusive and very evasive even when he's right in front of you, but...
Answer free, guys. Answer free. Stop.
Is a no punch, very, no punch, very no strong punch. Fighter. And he's still dangerous, so Warren's got can't be too...
Get off his head. Stop, stop, stop.
Here.
25 seconds, 22
hold
seconds
down punch,
left.
Right?
Round
Box.
Three. In the, what I call the Bam Bam division, the Bantamweights. They take a lick and they keep on
no
ticking.
Punch. Straight back. Box. This is for the belt, guys.
Yeah, he's just swarming on top of him there. Not effective punches, really. There was one.
Warren got the two best shots out of the whole exchange.
But,
take a look at what you're talking about with Akhunov. Akhunov here doing what he's trying to do to Warren.
There goes the swarm. He's taking three, four quick steps forward. He's pulling him on the ropes. He's pushing his shoulders back, pulling his head down, whatever it takes to get him to sit still for him. Now here's where he landed a good right hand, and now he's throwing a flurry at Akhunov and gives him a little shove out the ring. But a Warren just bounces right back in. Hey, look at him in the corner. He looks very confident. The coaches are saying, hey, you're doing well. Keep on going here. We're not out of this fight.
19 years old. Doesn't look a day over 13.
Back up, back up, back up, back up.
Round number four. This is the pivotal bout of the night. Rau'shee Warren trying to get his team a victory and keep himself undefeated in WSB. That quick right hand was nice.
Oh my God, hands up free, stop, stop, no punch.
Khabibulla Akhunov, the 19-year-old prodigy from Astana, just got hit another
one. Oh my God, hands up free, hands up free,
right
hands up free, stop, stop, no punch.
Warren switched up from the left hand, now he's going back to the right hand. The closest hand to Akhunov, so
oh my guys,
if he
hands
jumps
free,
in
hands
like
free.
It is, that's the one that's going to be closest to his face, the right one.
We're scheduled for five. All the fights in the World Series of Boxing go five rounds, five weight divisions.
Another great right
hook. My guys, hands are free. Hands are free.
Man, he was really talking to him over the corner.
No, he probably was telling him, don't get stuck on those ropes.
Stop,
again,
stop,
that's
fight.
When the kid looks his best.
Box.
That's when the kid lands his punches. Use the center of the ring. Use your side steps. And I bet he told him to go to that hook because he's thrown it three or four times already.
Watch your heads, guys. Watch your heads. Stop, stop. Wait. I see some. Come here. Got a little cut, headbutt. Box.
Yeah, no headgear. Something they have to learn.
Stop, stop. Wait. Straight back, guys.
When you use headgear,
guys, come on.
For years and years, you are protected, so you don't realize
up, right?
just how little it
up,
takes
right?
to cut. So you're a little bit more smart about that as a pro when you get the headgears off. Well, they're fighting like they still have headgears on. Great counter fight.
Stop, 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 stop.
and a good counter by Akhunov. He's in this fight, or in this round at least.
Stop! Break. Straight back.
But I gotta think that Rashid's seen many, many fighters that come at him like this.
Of course.
No.
Listen, when you get to this level, the top level, as these little guys, there's so many of them around the world that you've really gone through a lot. So you're this is the best of the best out there.
Let's go, guys. Hands are free.
A river shot by Akhunov. Another one. So the closer you are to a southpaw, the less advantage a southpaw has.
Another thing I haven't brought out, and I haven't had time, 28 seconds, is that these coaches have more than one fighter. They have a team that they can pick and choose matchups. So when the Astana team chose this fighter to go against Warren, they did it for a reason. Because they got two other bantamweights on the roster they could have picked. But this is the one they thought had the best shot here in the opening night.
And he's only 19. Listen for the bell. Stop. Great. Let's go. Five.
Round four done. Well, this could be closer than we think.
Akhunov had a fairly good round. What do you think?
This could be closer than we think. I'll say that much. I
would say that's his best round he's had.
Best round he's had, yeah.
I'd say Warren's, but ahead. Warren's ahead in my book right here.
I didn't think that Javi Torres in the heavyweight but it was a split decision. I thought it was a clear unanimous decision. So.
Well, I hate to break it to you. What we're talking about isn't official, but it's a hell of an opinion. Look, I got Rashi Warren up 3-1 right now.
Last round, we're going to touch him up.
Take a look at some of the action from that round, like you said. Akhunov's best round, perhaps.
There's that right hook. And look at Akhunov trying to come back with his own left hook right off the bat. Even though he got clipped with it, he still had enough wits about him to throw that.
This is the fifth round.
Let's go.
The final fight of the night, the final round. Can the captain of the LA Matadors, Rashid Babyshoot Warren, get his team?
Watch this.
I guess another guy who's a bit of a baby pit bull tonight. Akhunov.
Boy, great four punch combination by Rashid. He landed all four of those.
Get over here. Watch this back here. Don't do it again. You all right?
How many times has Tom Taylor said that tonight? Don't do it again, but he lets it keep fighting.
Well, that's all right. You know, he's not going to destroy a great fight so he can start taking straight points. Back. The guy listens to him, he'll let it go. Great hook.
Nice hook. The crowd Rashid put on a show here in the fifth and final round for the crowd. The crowd really reacting here in the sold-out house here in Hollywood.
Great defensive skills by Rashid. You see him dip.
What are you talking about?
Back, guys, no punch.
That was bouncing off the ropes from side to side. It tells you his quickness. Quick twitch muscles, as Gusev said. 138 left.
Hands are free. Come on.
Rashid Warren in the black trunks. Gold trim. Akhunov trying to swarm him.
He's trying anything he can right now just to get Warren to sit there and fight with him a little bit.
Listen to me. Don't push. Ready? Box.
It's a rough fight. He knows it. It's both of them are working hard, and he doesn't want to take a fight away from the kid who's already getting points taken away from him by Warren.
Strike back.
Warren's standing his ground pretty good in this onslaught because he's leaving a chance for him to hit him with his right hand. 55 seconds left in this fight night.
That right hook has been the difference in this past couple rounds for Warren.
Stop.
While Akhunov is trying to set up that straight right hand, he just throws that whip hook, catches him before he gets him out.
Self-assess. Hands are free.
35 seconds here.
Stop. Break.
Akhunov sometimes throws. He throws punches in the air before he even gets there.
Well, he starts feeling for you.
Break. Yeah. Break. Listen. Break. You. Last one. Box.
take it right down to the wire here tonight in Hollywood.
Time!
Warren looked fantastic. And this kid he was in front of made him earn every round that he won, let me tell you. It's a rough and tumble Akhunov.
He knew that's probably what he was going to be up against. He closed the show in grand style here in Hollywood. He's a Hollywood star tonight, Rau'shee Warren. We'll be back with the official decision and the announcement right after this and wrap up the night for you. It's time to find out the results of our feature fight tonight. Did the Matadors come all the way back tonight from a big deficit? Let's get it up to Michael Bale for the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of boxing action, we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge James Jenkins scores the bout 48-47, and both judges David Mendoza and Jerry Cantu scored the bout 49-46. For your winner by unanimous decision, Rau'shee Baby Pig.
One judge, a little closer than Joe Goosen and I had it, but 49-46, just about right. A game effort tonight from Khabibulla Akhunov. Let's take you through that left hook right there. Really came on in the end and made a big difference. And you see how Akhunov just misses, then he gets countered once again with a right hand. Baby Pitt has the quickness, and we mentioned names like Pernell Whitaker and that type of stuff as he develops along, that he makes you do things that don't work out very well, if that makes sense. Let's check in now with Hall of Fame trainer and our analyst, Joe Goosen, who's with Baby Pitt.
Can you hear me, Rau'shee? What, did this kid surprise you a little bit about how rugged he was?
It was a pretty good fight. I take my ass down to the young fighter. He only 19 and I'm 24. And he came in there with his game plan. But I stuck with my corner. So when you got a team in your corner, you come out with the victory.
On that flurry over there on the ropes where you went through the ropes, did he hit you with something good that knocked you back, or was you off balance?
No, over there in the corner, he had hit me with a good shot. And I try to move out of his other punches, and I kind of slipped. But he was a good fighter overall.
Now, it looked to me that in the fourth and fifth round, you kind of adjusted and started throwing more right hooks. Was that the case?
Yeah, that was a lot of case because he kept leaning in with his straight right hand. So I was trying to counter him with my hook over his right hand. Because the first two rounds, he kept hitting me with the same shot. So I listened to my corner and came out there and kept my composure and just stayed hungry and just kept fighting to the end.
And Rau'shee, let me ask you one last question here before we go. Did you think that you won every round of this fight, or do you think you dropped a couple?
I felt like I pulled it out for every round. No, because I had some big moments in each round.
You look great tonight, Rau'shee. Good luck to you in the future.
See you again.
So, for everyone here at Fox Sports, I'm Alan Massengill working with the great Joe Goosen. Come back and see us again sometime as we present more World Series of Boxing and LA against the world.